pretty, Granny. You gonna show me how to play your lap organ someday?
Sure, honey. Like my ma showed me, and like her ma showed her, and her ma before that.
Sure is old, ain't it?
Nigh on to 200 years.
Granny, reckon you can whop up a mess of spring tonic for old Duke and me? We is feeling like the hind quarters of bad luck.
I know what'll prick old Duke up. Can I give it to him, Granny?
If he wants it.
Of course he wants it, don't you, Duke? Look at here, Duke. Look at this nice bone. Oh, he must be sick.
Well, ain't exactly sick, Ellie Mae. We just both feeling ornery, dragged out, don't give two shucks for nothing. Granny, reckon you could brew up some of that tonic?
Sure. I could brew up a pot of Choctaw root, some cherry bark bitters, some red clover blossoms and sassafras. But I ain't gonna do it.
Why not?
'Cause that won't help what's ailing you and Duke.
Well, what do you reckon we got?
Ellie Mae, you go on outside. I want to talk to your pa.
Yes, Granny.
It ain't what you got. It's what you ain't got that's ailing you.
Well, what is it we ain't got?
Now, I could tell you in three words. Female company.
Female company. Got a house full of females. You, Ellie Mae, Pearl.
I ain't talking about female kinfolks.
Granny, is you suggesting that... Do you want... You... Granny, me and Duke is too old for that courting and sparking nonsense.
You ain't half too old. And a fine figure of a man, too. A heap lot better than them slick-haired, shiny-shoed, sweet-smelling city dudes.
Talking plumb silly. You gonna make the tonic or ain't you?
I ain't.
Come on, Duke. Let's just go hunting. Let me get our blood stirred up.
Depends on what you hunt.
How'd you like three bobcat?
See?
Yeah, that's all right. We get out in the woods, get to smelling bobcat tracks. Reckon you get the idea?
Well, if you want to get the idea, you go next door to the Drysdales and smell some orange blossoms. I think they're getting ready for a wedding.
Drysdale? Wonder who's getting hitched.
I don't know. Must be some kin of Miss Drysdale's. She's been frolicating around like a chicken in the corn crib.
Oh, happy day. Greetings, all. Miss Drysdale.
Margaret, I've asked you not to barge in here while I'm working.
Oh, pish-posh. What's more important than our darling getting married?
Sonny's getting married?
Oh, no, no, no. Dear Claude is getting married.
Congratulations, Claude.
Margaret. Dogs do not get married, they mate.
Milburn, don't be crude. I prefer to consider Claude and his beautiful Parisian bride as entering wedlock.
Parisian bride?
Darling, I told you last week I was having a bride for Claude flown in from Paris. Really, Milburn, you don't listen. All you think about is your silly old bank.
Forgive me, dear. Congratulations, Claude.
His nail polish may not be dry.
He's just come from the poodle parlor. He had a clip and a manicure and a dye job.
I thought he was a different color.
It's becoming, isn't it? And so natural. Only his hairdresser knows for sure.
Miss Hathaway, I'll need you today.
Oh, what for? A bridesmaid?
Oh, of course not, Milburn. I'll need her as an interpreter. You see, Mademoiselle Denise speaks almost no English.
Very few poodles do.
Really, Milburn, you just don't pay attention. Mademoiselle Denise is the owner of Claude's bride-to-be. She's flying her here personally for the nuptials.
Well, let's all go home and meet the bride.
Well, don't you want to be there?
Oh, more than anything else in the world, dear, but I'd better stay here and work. After all, I have Claude's wedding to pay for, and soon there'll be other little mouths to feed.
Oh, yes. Isn't that a thrilling thought?
Milburn,
People won't call me a grandmother, will they?
Oh, of course not, dear. Of course not.
Not.
I'll call you a nut.
Get outside, both of you. House ain't no place for cleaning guns. I got everything spick and span, and I'd like it to stay that way for a while.
Well, now, listen, look, Prairie, wait a minute. My hat's in there and my box of cartridges.
Here's your hat. There's your cartridges.
I swear to goodness, if she ain't the cleanest woman,
she had her way. She'd have slip covers on the wall.
Don't you let her get you down, then, Duke. This city living is what's got us feeling bottom heavy. Just wait till Jethro gets back. We get him to drive us way out in the woods. Three of us will light out through the tall timber. We'll have us a high old time. How's that sound to you? Jethro better get here pretty quick.
Pardon, monsieur. Est-ce que c'est la maison de Madame Drysdale?
Excuse me, ma'am, but I didn't quite get what you said there.
Is this the Drysdale home?
Oh, no, ma'am. Drysdale place is next one over yonder.
Yonder?
Behind them tall trees there. Come this way and I'll show it to you. Now, sight twixt them first and second trees there, you catch a glimpse of the Drysdale house. See?
Ah, oui.
Now, you come mite further, you can see more of it.
Aimable, monsieur. Je suis votre débiteuse.
No offense, ma'am, but you're kind of hard to understand. Where about you from?
Je ne vous comprends pas.
Oh, well, I bet you it's a nice place.
Merci beaucoup. Au revoir.
Yeah, well, thank you. Same to you and many more of them. She's a mighty handsome-looking woman. Smelled pretty, too, didn't she, Duke? Duke? Where'd you go, Duke?
Granny? Granny!
Granny!
Yeah, Pearl?
Do you know who's got a secret, sweetheart?
No, Pearl. But hum it for me. I'll pick it up.
It ain't a song, Granny.
It's Jed.
She's got a lady friend. And she's pretty, too.
Well, the old rooster took my advice.
Hey, Granny, hey, Pearl, look at old Duke. He's got a new friend.
Well, by dingies, they both took my advice. I reckon maybe I'll take it next myself.
Paul, have you seen Duke's new friend, Cotton Patch?
Well, no, I ain't. Come on up here and let's take a look at you.
Isn't she pretty? I named her Cotton Patch because her hair grows in clumps.
I reckon it was clipped that way, Ellie Mae, but the fella that done it must have had the clippers in one hand and a jug in the other. He missed the biggest part of her.
Oh, Duke sure has took a fancy to her. He dug up four of his best bones and give them to her.
She done a lot for Duke, too. Before she come along, Duke was feeling lower in a snake's belly in a wagon rut, but look at him now.
Yeah. Look at this here collar that Cotton Patch was wearing. I was afeard she'd catch it in the bushes running after Duke, so I took it off.
Ain't that fancy. Duke, are you sure you ain't after that girl just for her money?
Heck of them's diamonds, Paul?
Might could be. Ellie Mae, this dog belongs to somebody. Somebody that sets great store by her, too. Folks don't just get... Thank you.
l'on merveilleux. Vous avez trouvé mon chien bien aimé.
I reckon this must be the party that owns Cotton Patch. I'll put her in the car for you, ma'am. There you are, ma'am.
Granny, I tell you, I seen it with my own eyes. Jed and this handsome-looking city woman walking along, arm in arm, just like they was a pair of lovers. Oh, that sly old Dickens. Where was he? Right out front there, and in broad daylight. Come on, I'll show you. Right where they was. Pearl Bodine, shame on you. You gonna spy on your own cousin? I sure am. Me too.
Oh, monsieur, je ne sais pas comment vous remercier, mais peut-être que ça vous démontre mes vrais sentiments.
Say, ma'am, here's something I reckon you'd like to have.
Oh, monsieur, je vous remercie encore une fois, mille fois merci. Merci, mon ami.
Did you see what he gave her? A diamond choker. Yeah, must have cost old Jed a fortune. Jed, here we go.
Your hand this way's a shining.
Hey, Granny.
Yeah, Pearl.
I've been you had a ball driving up in a fancy car and a hugging and a kissing you. Wouldn't you want your kinfolk to meet that beau?
I sure would, Pearl. Especially if I was giving that beau expensive presents.
You mean like a diamond choker?
That's what I mean.
You know, I hear tell that French women is real fond of jewelry.
If you two are trying to make something out of what just happened outside, you can leave off before you get started. All I was doing was returning that lady's dog, and that diamond choker was the dog's collar.
Say, Granny.
Yeah, Pearl.
What do you reckon that red stuff was smeared on Jed's cheek?
I reckon he cut himself returning that dog.
Either that or his lady friend scratched herself on his whiskers when she kissed him.
That must be real love, Pearl, if you can kiss a man with a crop of stubble on his face like that.
You better believe it, Granny.
Here we are, the bridal suite. I do hope you like it. I decorated it all myself. I used as much French silk as I could find. The orange blossoms are from our own tree. And these are Claude's trophies.
Ce sont à Claude. Ah, bon.
Well, if everything is in order, I'd like to have Claude come in. He's never seen the bridal suite. Nor his bride, of course.
It's bad luck.
La chambre est-elle confortable?
Ah, bien sûr.
Mademoiselle Denise is delighted with the appointment.
Marvelous. I've arranged with the butler to release Claude as soon as he hears the music. I'll start the record now. A beautiful moment. I just know I'm going to cry. Come, Claude, you handsome groom. Your lovely bride is waiting.
Going hunting now?
You go, Jethro. I don't feel much like hunting.
But that's why you said you wanted to go.
You said you and old Duke was feeling all dragged out and ornery, and you wanted to go hunting to get your blood to stirring. That's what you said.
Well, I ain't saying it now. Why don't you go ahead without me?
But I don't need to go hunting to stir my blood. It's already stirring.
Well, now stir it some more.
You keep turning away from me, Uncle Jed. Done shaved. Hey, Ma, Granny, Ellie Mae. Come see Uncle Jed shaved in the middle of the day.
Ethro, hush. Ain't you never seen a man with a shave before?
Not you. Not unless there's a wedding or a funeral to go to. Look at yonder at Uncle Jed.
Oh, great clouds of buggy dust.
He's got rolled off his stubble.
Trimmed his mustache.
In the middle of the day.
Tarnation.
Look at his hair.
Oh, you're pretty.
Ain't it stylish?
It's got smellum on it.
Things have come to a sorry state when a man can't shave his face and comb his hair without his family cackling like a bunch of chickens at a new worm.
Why, Cousin Jed, that ain't a nice thing to call your sweetie.
Jed got a sweetie?
City woman. Talks foreign. Drives a sporty car.
Dresses to the teeth.
Wears jewelry.
Given to her by your Uncle Romeo. I mean, Jed.
Diggity!
Oh, am I gonna have a new ma?
Oh, you ain't. I ain't gonna listen to more of this nonsense talk. Howdy, ladies.
Mademoiselle Denise, Monsieur Clampett.
Nous nous connaissons.
Oh, you two have met.
Yes, ma'am.
Mais Monsieur Clampett a changé.
She says you look different.
Oh, shucks, it's because I mowed off my whiskers and combed my hair.
Very becoming. Oh, will you keep Duke here? He's upsetting the wedding ceremony at the Drysdales.
It ain't her to get married, is it?
Oh, no, indeed.
Monsieur, je vous préfère comme vous êtes sans barbe.
We have to hurry. Now, you will keep Duke here.
Yes, ma'am.
Monsieur Clampett, gardez le chien ici.
Ah, vous êtes toujours si aimable et obligeant.
Is calming the bride's nerves. They'll be right in.
Good, good. This delay is so difficult for Claude. I hope he doesn't get one of his migraines.
Well, the perfume.
I want to eradicate every vestige of that horrid beast from next door. Claude must never know.
What in the name of FHA is this?
Oh, you've come for the ceremony.
No, I've come for my secretary. Margaret, this used to be my den. And there's where my TV set was.
And now it's a love nest for Claude and his beautiful bride. Milburn, doesn't it thrill you?
I can hardly stand it.
This is Mademoiselle Denise, and this is my...
Yes, we've met. Come on, Miss Hathaway, let's get back to the bank.
Oh, no, dear. Claude is about to meet his new bride. Would you like to give her away?
Can I give them both away?
Oh, dear boy. Darling, you bring Claude in. He'll feel more secure with his dadums at his side.
Qu'est-ce que c'est que ça?
Oh, the dog next to... Le chien de nos voisins, Duke.
I'll close the window so that... We... Oh, here's the handsome groom. This is a magic moment. Come here. Oh, what a cruel blow. Quick, Milburn, call the psychiatrist.
Yours or his?
Uncle Jed! Is we going hunting or are you going court?
What you talking about? I ain't going courting.
Then we's going hunting.
Julie, I didn't want to go hunting. Now, you go yourself and take Duke with you.
Well, Duke don't want to go hunting. Well, he's outside right now, frisking around with that there white dog that Ellie Mae calls Cotton Patch.
Is she, man?
She sure is. Old Duke's happier than a cat at a fish fry. He's running and jumping and just playing around and... What are you holding under the table, Uncle Jay?
Oh, none of your business. Now get up.
Why, you're polishing your shoes.
Hey, Mom! Granny, Ellie Mae! Uncle Jim's polishing his shoes and it ain't even Sunday.
Jethro, you do make more racket than a jackass in a tin bar. Claire, this is the nosiest family a man was ever burdened with.
Well, look at them shoes, all fresh oiled.
That's in new laces, too.
And them's his best socks.
And it ain't even Sunday.
Son, every day's Sunday when you're in love.
Now that takes a rag off in the bush. I ain't in love, and I just oiled my shoes because they were squeaking.
They've been squeaking for 15 years, as I remember. You ain't never oiled them.
Youngins, you go and get outside. Granny and me's got some grown-up things to say.
I ain't gonna listen to no more foolishness.
Now, Jed, you hadn't ought to fight against romance. You're still young and good-looking.
And you're rich, too.
Yeah. And with that, you don't need young and good-looking.
That reminds me. I dug something out of the mothballs for you. Your necktie and your derby that you wore when you came a-courting Rose Ellen, all dooted up and stepping out like a chicken in high oats.
I got something for you, too, Jay.
Your fancy cotton shirt.
I'm gonna put this stuff back where it belongs, and I don't want to hear no more words about roaming.
Where are you going?
I'm going out and dig myself a root cellar and crawl in and lock it so I can get a little peace and quiet.
What you say, Mrs. Drysdale?
I said Claude's honor has been besmirched, and I demand satisfaction. Poor Claude is in a state of shock. Now I demand that Claude's bride be returned immediately.
Yes, ma'am. Ellie will bring her right over.
Phew. Eddie, you better get that poodle over there fast.
I sure will.
Hold on, Ellie Bean. I'm going to take that dog back to the Drysdales, and Duke, you're coming along.
What?
It seems to me that critters ought to have the same right as people to pick their own company. So we're going over there, and Cotton Patch, you can make up your mind who you want to court. Just like I made up mine.